Hello friends, good morning. The topic for today is enzyme inhibition and I'll be mainly discussing about competitive inhibition. There are a number of questions which have come in the university exams on competitive inhibition, and these are the type of questions which has come. Mainly a description of what is competitive inhibition with suitable examples or the characteristic features of competitive inhibition and its importance in medicine with examples. And the third type of question which has come is also the features of competitive inhibition with three clinically important examples with explanation. Now, first of all, you should define what is enzyme inhibition. Enzyme inhibition is brought about, that is, there is a decrease in the enzyme activity, and this is brought about by chemical substances known as negative modifiers or inhibitors. And you say that there are three different types of inhibition: competitive, non-competitive and uncompetitive inhibition. And you go on to describe what is competitive inhibition. Define competitive inhibition. The inhibitor is structurally similar and it competes with the substrate for the catalytic site. So the binding between the inhibitor and the enzyme will depend on the affinity which the enzyme has for the substrate or for the inhibitor. It will also depend upon the concentration of the substrate or the inhibitor, and will also depend upon the time of pre-incubation the enzyme has with the substrate or the inhibitor. It is a reversible process. Now, something more about the competitive inhibition, that is regarding its kinetics. What is its effect on Vmax? So the effect of competitive inhibitor is reversed on increasing the substrate concentration. So if you keep on increasing the substrate concentration, at high levels of substrate concentration, the maximum velocity will reach a level observed when there is no inhibitor, that is in the absence of the inhibitor. What is its effect on Km? Now, the competitive inhibitor will increase the apparent Km for a given substrate. And this, why does this happen? Because there is a decreased affinity of the substrate with the enzyme active site. So in the presence of a competitive inhibitor, more substrate is required to achieve the Km. So it is best to show the kinetics as the Lineweaver-Burk plot, where we plot 1 by V versus 1 by S. It is 1 by velocity versus 1 by substrate concentration. And the red line shows what happens in the case of a competitive inhibitor. We find that, and the yellow line shows that what happens when there is no inhibitor. So we find that the velocity or the Vmax is not changed. Okay. But what is changing is the Km. So in the presence of a competitive inhibitor, what happens? The Km is increased. Why is the Km increased? Because the affinity of the enzyme for the substrate decreases. So the rate of the enzyme reaction will decrease, but the procedure, it's a reversible process, and so the procedure can be reversed by increasing the concentration of the substrate. Now, from metabolism, these are some examples of competitive inhibitors of certain enzymes. For example, in the case of lactate dehydrogenase, lactate is the substrate and oxamate is the competitive inhibitor. In the case of succinate dehydrogenase, succinate is the substrate and malonate is the competitive inhibitor, and so on for other enzymes. Clinically, what is the utility of these competitive inhibitors? That is shown in this table. There are a lot of examples where we have clinically used these competitive inhibitors. For example, in the case, the inhibitor allopurinol inhibits the enzyme xanthine oxidase. The substrate is hypoxanthine or xanthine, and this has been used in the treatment of gout. In the case of cholesterol metabolism, the inhibitor lovastatin or compactin is a competitive inhibitor of HMG-CoA reductase, where the substrate is HMG-CoA. So it will inhibit cholesterol synthesis, and these statins are cholesterol lowering drugs. Methotrexate inhibits the enzyme dihydrofolate reductase and it's an anti-cancer drug. Sulfonylamides, they are a competitive inhibitor of dihydroteroate synthase. So this will inhibit the bacterial synthesis of folic acid. And so on, like succinyl-CoA inhibits the enzyme acetylcholine esterase, and so it's used as a muscle relaxant in patients who are receiving anesthesia. So whatever the type of question is, if it is competitive, you will have to give the description of what is competitive inhibition, what is the kinetics involved. You have to show the Lineweaver-Burk plot, and you have to give the examples where these competitive inhibitors are used in clinical medicine as drugs. Okay, so this finishes the topic on competitive inhibition. Thank you.